Alright everybody, welcome to my playthrough of the Kerbal Space Program 0.22 Career Mode with the top 12 mods as listed by PC Gamer 2013. So first I'm going to overview my settings with you guys, just show you what kind of settings I'm running through. My max physics delta time is 0.03, that's generally kind of important. All my graphics are maxed out. And the audio is turned way down. Music's off. So cancel that out so it doesn't. So as you can see, the Kethane mod's already working. Basically, the Kethane mod, for those of you that don't know, is you scan the planet for Kethane, which is a very powerful fuel, and these little grid indicators tell you where it is. And I think they're going to add more resources eventually on the mod, but hopefully the actual game program will do that. So let's jump right in here. So the saved one I have is a sandbox, but do career mode. Well, let's call it, and we're gonna pick our flag to be. Ooh, there's some new ones. Oh, those are the different packs. Ooh, I like that one. No. Nah, let's do trippy. Do the trippy flag. Alright. It is very early this morning, so my alarm clock might go off a few times while we're working on this, but the first thing we want to do is just, you know, show you guys, I mean, I'm sure most of you play career mode already. Tree, this is all we have right now, and these mods that I installed are in the trees. So eventually we will start seeing some stuff like this one from the mods. So anyway, let's go to the Space Center. And that's weird, their heads are not. One of the mods is supposed to change like the planet textures. Oh wow, the Space Center looks pretty good. One of the mods is supposed to change the planet textures to kind of make them look better, and one of the mods, and part of that mod is supposed to like change some of the Kerbal's faces, so the Kerbals have different faces. I don't know why that's not. Maybe just in these little icons it's not working. We'll see here. So the first thing we want to do is go and build a couple rockets, and from my last video, what I figured out is that you can recover your spacecraft as long as it lands on Kerbal. You can recover it, so any science that you saved instead of transmitted will be kept. So we don't have to use a stupid ass transmitter unless we don't plan on returning to Kerbal. What the fuck is? Oh, okay. I do have the FAR control systems, which is like the super crazy realistic thing. How do I? Okay, just get out of my way. Damn it. I just moved it a second ago. There we go. Okay, get. I don't know how to get rid of this. Get out of the way. Okay. Sorry, guys. Okay. So, crew capsule. We're just gonna go kind of crazy here. Parachute. And this stack thing is really pissing me off that it doesn't stack properly anymore. I really hope they fix that. So structural utility, we don't have any what's it called, science experiments. Apparently the science experiments are pretty useful. So, and I don't really need to save, but I mean, booster, let's call it booster one. I don't know, you know, action groups and crew, don't really need those. Save, and my little recording icon, you guys can't see it, is right over the exit button. That's gonna bother the shit out of me, but all right, let's launch. So now that we can actually recover our ships, which I don't know if that's a mod or if it's actually part of the game, because I didn't see it until after I installed all 12 mods. This recover vessel. I don't know if this is part of the game or not, but apparently that's really important to getting science. Okay, so now the far flight systems is where it belongs. So what we can do is we can do a crew report. We can save the data, so we don't have to transmit it. All right, now we can just hit our SAS, and go. So that was Chatterer, as you just heard. It's actually pretty cool, I like it. I need to change some of my settings. 3, 5, 15, beep 1, 2 is off, 3 is off. Sliders, we're gonna do this. As little chatter as we can get. Alright, so the booster just ran out. We were going hella fast. Chatter, Quindar volume. Okay, SSTV. What's SSTV? Wait. What's the difference between SSTV and chatter? Okay. So something, make it a little more realistic, I guess. It's kind of cool. The little beeping is, could get annoying, but I can always turn it down. 5 to 15 is a little annoying. Let's do 15 to 30. I don't know. Spaceships are supposed to beep, right? Okay, so I guess I can, what's going on here? I guess I can time warp us out of this. Man, are we even coming back to Kerbal? Okay. Oh, wait, what am I doing? Stop the time warp for a sec. No. Oh, man, I think I missed my chance. Crew report. Overwrite existing crew report. What? Oh, I can't save more than one piece of data at a time? That doesn't make sense. Apparently, he's like, I'm coming in
front. That way, we're going to be down here, type up there, good night.
Wow. Might have to change that to a little less frequent. I wonder what the SSTV is supposed to be. Alright, so we're coming in hot. Deploy our drogue chute. Oh man, I hope I don't hit this mountain range. Oh, what is that? Why is that doing that? Oh, do I still have SSS? Oh shit, stop doing that. How is that even possible? I heard Far Flight Systems has some issue with parachutes. Oh fuck me. Open the parachute! Son of a bitch. Oh, who did we just kill? Jebediah. We killed Jebediah. The most popular character in Kerbal's dead. Great. I'm a bad pilot. How the fuck did that happen? Yeah, apparently that's a pretty big glitch, is that the rocket will flip around sometimes in the far realistic blah blah blah. Alright. And there's my alarm clock. Alright. Ooh, we're getting all glitchy now. Why the hell are we getting all glitchy? Yep, there's some different Kerbal faces. See? Gray guy. Or his mustache guy. He's got to be around here somewhere. But anyway. Ooh, it's all glitchy now. I don't like that. Why is it all... I probably should have set a timer for this episode. Anyway, alright, we're going to do... Do I have decouplers? I don't. We're going to try this. Do something stupid. I don't know. Booster 2. See if we can actually make it back home this time. Launch. Because I need that science. That's weird. I could have swore you could save multiple things of science, unless that was part of a mod, which is going to make this much, much more difficult. Okay. Obviously, throttles don't really matter, but just turn it up for posterity. And go. I'm gonna try to say something. Probably for the best. That way we don't end up out of the atmosphere. We can just get some interesting in-air science. I don't like flying without MechJeb. Oh my god, look at that. I'm so glad that I don't have the mod that gives atmospheric, you know, temperature damage. Alright, do a new crew report. I don't understand what it means by overwrite, but we'll see. Alright, deploy our drone ship. I'm not gonna deploy yet, but now I am gonna go up out into space. Damn, they're pretty chatty. Okay, what the hell is with the extra beeps? Okay, that's SSTV. We don't need any of that. That's annoying. Whatever the hell that is. Alright, anyway. And that's my alarm clock. Okay. Come on now. Get out of physics warp. Right. And back to physics warp. Okay, so now the rocket's turning. Okay, the parachute's out. So I don't understand why it's flipped around. This is gonna cause it to explode again. Fuck, come on, the parachute should be more powerful than aerodynamics. Oh, this is bad. This guy's gonna die. Fuck. Oh, shit. Come on, don't die this time. I need the science. I wanna unlock new stuff. Crap. This is not good. Need to unlock some slope. Yes, we're gonna live this time. Good. Alright, don't die when you land. Don't die, please. Ow! Success! Alright, I heard you're supposed to EVA and get a soil sample. Alright, welcome back, everybody. Apparently, the game crashed on me when I tried to EVA. So, I don't even know if we were... It might have saved it. Let's try it out. See if it saved the mission. I'm not happy about that at all. Is it on the launch pad? Whoops. I thought this one crashed. What is it loading? What are you loading? What? Okay, I've never seen this dialogue on the launch pad before. Clear launch pad. I guess those are quick launches? Autosave. Close. Crew center. And that's more crew. Close. Don't have any science. Damn it. Okay. Open booster 2. So, actually try to have a successful mission this time. How about that? That would be nice.
Wouldn't it?
Make sure all my settings on this stupid alarm clock. Shh. Okay. Already awake. SSTV. Alright, that's alright. So. I'm just gonna fly through the atmosphere here and try to get some frickin' science. So mad. Oh, about to crash to the ground. Nope. Alright, I'm running out of fuel. Quick! Parachute! Oh yeah, this could be bad. Still don't understand how the aerodynamics are more powerful than the aerodynamics of a parachute. Okay, how do I... Alright, we're actually gonna land this time. Somewhere safe in the ocean.
Hopefully we can get some science.
And I ought to be without meds.
Alright. Scientific value of 12 for that? Oh, hell yeah. Store experiments. How do I get back in? Uh-oh. Am I stuck out here? Can I just recover? Okay. How much science do I get from that? Zero science? What? I recovered the vessel. How do I get no science from recovering the goddamn... Really? So was that a mod he was using? Oh, now I'm mad. This is fucking stupid. I hate career mode. Alarm clock, shush. Do I really have to transmit the damn data? You've got to be joking. You think they'd at least include a battery, you know, in the initial... This makes me mad. And the game's all freaking glitchy again. What is going on? This is starting to not be a good series. So I got an antenna. Still got all this crap. Booster 3. Starting to get really annoyed at this science stuff. I wonder if that was a mod, or if I just did something wrong. Maybe I have to be back in the ship?
I don't know. It's kind of disappointing.
Alright, I guess before we even run our motors, can transmit some science. Crew report, transmit. And it uses hella electricity, but now we can... Oh, we're not getting the electric charge back. Why is that? This rocket's basically a waste. Electric charge, that's great. I probably shouldn't have deployed the parachute like that. Oh well. Not too concerned at this point. I don't even have decouplers. I'm in orbit, apparently. Parachute's not really doing anything at this altitude. Man, how high am I gonna go? It's gonna run out of electricity. That's not gonna be good. Sorry about that. I keep forgetting that you have to unmute. And here we go with the weird physics again. Do not understand that at all. Come on, don't die. Please don't die. I need the science. The extra science. Oh. Okay. Not gonna EVA this time. Splash. Alright, do a crew report. Alright, so the game crashed again, so I might have to uninstall everything and maybe pick and choose which of the 12 mods I'd like to use. Yeah. Anyway, we're gonna keep trying. See if we got any science from I guess we transmitted science. I don't know if the recover button, if it crashed before or after I clicked recover. One science. Really? I hate career mode. It sucks. Somebody needs to explain to me how the hell this science thing works, because I've seen lots of people just hit the recover vessel, and then the science magically appears after they saved it. So either I'm doing something wrong, I don't know. Somebody help me out. It's starting to piss me off, because all right, let's try a liquid rocket. I forgot the transmitter. Alright, let's try it again. Where is it? There it is. Save and launch. These videos are going to get a lot more interesting, I promise. I just need to get past the initial couple stages of science-y crap. Alright, how much is this crew report worth? 0.6, so just keep the data. Now, let's get the hell as far into space as we can and make another report, shall we? And this is all fucked up again. Do that. That. Go! Oh, that was a lot. Okay. Go ahead and get our drag chute going. We can transmit some science. Or 3.5. Data uploaded, 3.5 science added. Now I have no electricity left for more science, which is so angering. Now we gotta come down. Okay, turn off the time warp so the parachute can deploy without exploding. We're literally right above. Yeah, that was successful. As my phone goes off. Emails. Better get some damn science this time. Keep data. See, I feel like, I don't know, I feel like green is keep data, green is recover vessel. It should match, damn it. I don't know why it's not working. Okay, don't explode. Don't explode. Ah! Oh, we're alive. Okay. Cover. Did I get science from that? Oh, see, now I get science. So why didn't it work last time? I guess because it locked up. Alright, good. Now we can unlock some stuff. It's about fucking time, isn't it? Research. Now. Landing struts, liquid fuel, parachute, nose cone, winglet, decoupler. Ooh, I want a decoupler. Rocket separation booster. Ooh, these are some nice engines, though. I'm going to go with the radial decoupler so I can start making bigger rockets. Wait, 18 science. Holy crap. Never mind. I guess I need more science. All right, let's see what we can build with this stuff. I think this... Oh, no, there are decouplers on level 2 now. Okay, I don't think... Those were included before the mods. Alright guys, so next episode we're going to make our real rocket, so hit me up then.